Hello.
Welcome to yoga.
Hope everyone is feeling well and healthy this morning. My name is Nicola. This is an all levels practice. Today I will be introducing, ta-da, the yoga block. Right now you may be thinking, great, I don't have one of those. No worries. If you don't have a block, and you've done my practices before, this will be just the same. It's very doable without any props at all. I just thought, since I now have one, I would introduce you to it and show you how it may help with some of the postures, aid you in getting correct alignment if you're having trouble keeping a straight spine, or you know, you have other issues, so they can be helpful. If you have one, throw me on pause, go grab it, or even a rolled up towel, kind of a tightly rolled up towel, can help too. Again, if you don't have one, it does not matter. I have a cork block right here, which I like. It's a little heavy, but the reason I like it is because of the weight. So any configuration you want to place it in to assist you, it's pretty stable. There are foam blocks out there, they're just as good. They are lighter weight, so, you know, it's all personal preference. So place this aside for now. And again, if you do not have one, no worries. It is very doable without any props at all. So just come to a nice tall spine and we'll begin with our centering. So making room here for the breath by sitting tall. We'll come into the three-part or dirgha breath. So initially on your inhale, I want you to allow the belly to soften and expand like a balloon. And as you exhale, draw belly button towards spine, using the abdominals to help fully exhale. So at your own pace here, just inhaling and exhaling, allowing belly to expand. Just waking up the lower part of the lungs. So I do want to give a quick shout out to my sister Hannah this morning. Hi Hannah. I was actually feeling super tired and unmotivated this morning. And she messaged me and said, oh, I'm doing your yoga, I love it. So it spurred me on to kind of get some energy and get going here. So thank you, Hannah, for that. Sometimes we need that extra little push to help us. And it was her this morning. So just beginning to bring in part two of the three-part breath. As you inhale, allow belly and then rib cage to expand. And as you exhale, actively draw in the ribs, draw in the belly button. And just begin to scan your body here. Check in with yourself, see how you feel today. Maybe you're feeling a little tired and unmotivated, but you're here, you're practicing. So step one is making it to the mat, right? I will do my best to spur you on. So just noting those areas where you need to take care of yourself this morning, where you may need to modify. And being okay with that, being accepting of that. Just keep in mind this is your own personal practice, so do what you can. And hopefully by the end, you'll feel a little more relaxed, a little calmer, a little more physically aware than you did when we started. And bringing in the third and final part of our three-part breath. Allow belly, ribcage, then collarbones to expand on your inhale. And as you exhale, collarbones fall, ribs draw in, belly button pulls in. Just taking these deep, slow, full breaths. getting the sense that we're breathing from bottom to top on the inhale and emptying from top to bottom with the exhale. Taking one more deep full breath. Exhale. And then just allow your breathing to be natural without too much thought. We'll begin by moving into bound angle. So just bringing the soles of your feet together and allowing your knees to just fall out to the side. It's important initially here to have a tall, straight spine. So you may want to do as I'm doing right now and just place your hands behind you. Kind of use them as props to prop your spine up nice and tall. If you prefer, you can kind of hold onto your ankles, and as you lean forward slightly, use your elbows to encourage your thighs a little closer to the floor. If hips are really tight, just push your feet a little further forward. This will allow you to sit more forward on your sit bones and allow you to keep a straight spine. And you can stay here with this nice long spine, or if you want to and are able to, you can just begin to round the spine, bringing nose towards the earth. One more option here is to come into turtle. So you would want to definitely push your feet further forward here. You take your hands, palms down, kind of reach them underneath your lower legs and bring your forearms down to the mat. Back can remain straight, or again, you can round the spine. And if you want, you can even take your hands and place them on the tops of your feet here, or the sides of your feet. These are all just options, so pick what works for you. One more breath here, and then just release the posture, come to a nice tall spine. If your feet are not forward, go ahead and push them forward. Bring your hands behind you, coming into seated fish. It's a little chest opener, so you'll want to draw your shoulder blades together. And then open up and expand the upper part of the chest. You can look straight up at the ceiling or straight ahead, depending on how your neck feels. Allow the inhale breaths to expand this upper chest area as we hold this posture. Releasing the shoulder blades here. Just bring your feet a little wider than hip width apart. And we'll just kind of allow the legs here to just rock gently from side to side. Just releasing those hips. And then coming to stillness. Extend your left leg forward, flexing your foot, and draw your right leg in. I should just also note I am trying to mirror image, which I usually do when I teach a live class. So it's a case of do as I say, not as I do. because I actually have my right foot forward now, but extend your left foot forward, sitting nice and tall. This right foot can stay to the inside of your thigh or cross over to the outside of the thigh. Take an inhale breath, and as you exhale, we'll be coming into a twist here. So just begin to wring out the spine by twisting. You can complete the twist by turning the head, if that's okay, in the neck. And options with the arms here are just to hug this right knee, or maybe take your arm to the outside of the thigh and push against it to help ease you a little deeper into the twist. Front foot is flexed and active. Sitting a little taller with each inhale, twisting a fraction more with each exhale. Legs as they are, just take the upper body in the opposite direction, finding that counter twist. Again, keeping the spine nice and long. Inhaling here, and on your exhale, release the twist. Extend both legs forward, maybe give them a little shake, keeping your right leg forward, draw your left leg in. It can remain on the inside or cross over to the outside of this right leg. Inhale here, and as you exhale, begin to twist towards the left side. Wringing out the spine.
Standing on the platform, watching you go. It's like no other pain.
Take an inhale breath here. And as you exhale, just release that, finding the counter twist of keeping your legs exactly where they are. We'll twist in the opposite direction here. Into a seated forward fold from here. I'm going to actually turn on my mat here. So if you have really loose hamstrings and you know you can do a forward fold by keeping your legs straight, that's awesome. Hamstrings are tight, you'll want to bend your legs here and just have a gap between your knees and the mat. And this is where you could actually use a block. It's really not necessary, but if you want, you can just kind of rest your knees here on the block and find that forward fold. If you don't have a block or you're not using the block, you can just keep that bend in the knee and make sure when you come forward, rest your belly on your thigh. And you can kind of, as you hold this stretch, try to ease your heels a little further forward every breath or two. Even if they go a millimeter, it's still a victory, right? And as I said, if your legs are straight, if hamstrings are loose, then that's awesome. Go ahead and find your version of the forward fold. You can keep a flat spine, or you can bring forearms down to the mat, or maybe even begin to just round the spine, bringing nose toward knee. So take it to where you need it to go today. Next inhale, just make your way upright. And we'll be coming onto the hands and knees and doing the 6 movements of the spine. So make sure your joints are stacked, knees and hips, wrists, elbows, shoulders. And moving into some cat dog or cat cow as we inhale, belly lowers, tailbone and chin tip up. As you exhale, round the spine, push into your hands and knees a little bit and tuck in your chin and tailbone. Inhale, find that dog posture, belly lowers, looking up. Exhale, into cat. You can continue to just flow back and forth with your own breath. If you want to make this a little bit of a flow, as you exhale towards that cat, you can bring your hips towards your heels. And then as you inhale, kind of sweeping your nose across the mat, finding your way up into dog posture. So again, this is your own practice. Whatever would feel really good, whatever your body is asking for, just listen and try to honor that. Take one more inhale breath. Exhale, rounding the spine, finding that cat posture. And then coming to a neutral spine. And from here, we'll just find that little C curve side to side. So as you exhale, take your chin and hips to the left side, looking back towards your hips. Inhale as you pass through center. Exhale, take hips and chin to the right. Just making this little curve side to side, exhaling as the spine curves, and inhaling as you pass through a straight spine. Moving with the breath, making it a nice slow flow from one side to the other. Go once more either side. And then we'll work with a little thread, the needle, keeping left hand grounded. Inhale, open right arm for a twist. And then as you exhale, thread this arm, palm up, push out through the fingertips, and then coming down onto the mat. So if head comfortably rests on the mat, go for it. Otherwise, if you need a little more support, you can make a fist. Or you could actually use also the yoga block here to assist you by resting your head on the block. If you want, releasing this left arm, kind of draping it behind your back, opening up the left shoulder a little bit. Take one more breath, and then if the left arm was tucked behind your back, bring palm to mat. Inhale, open right arm for a twist, and exhale, come back to that tabletop. Inhaling, open up your left arm, exhale, thread the needle. If you can, bringing head and shoulder down to the mat, or finding some support for the head. If the right arm is free, feel free to drape it behind your back. Take one more breath here. Return right hand to mat if it was draped behind your back. And with an inhale, just on thread the needle here, opening for one more twist, bringing hands to mat. And we'll prepare for downward facing dog. So tucking your toes under, maybe take the hands a little further forward off your shoulders. And begin to lift up your hips, push back into your feet here, pushing your heels down. towards the mat. Push into the palms of your hands so that your chest comes back towards your thighs. And taking attention to your tailbone, just kind of tip it up and back a little bit like we did with the dog posture earlier. And draw your shoulder blades down your back and then wrap them forward. You can feel free to hold here if you're enjoying this downward dog as is. As always, soft bend in the knees or a generous bend if that's what you need. One more option is to come up onto the toes here and alternately just push one heel then the other down in towards the mat. Pushing into the opposite palm of the hand as you do so, walking the dog. And then coming to stillness, we'll just begin to walk the feet towards the front of the mat, landing in a forward fold. If forward folds are not for you, then pick the jackknife option, keeping torso parallel to the floor, head and heart at the same level. If you're okay with forward folds, go ahead and relax forward, soft bending the knees. You can actually bring your yoga block in front of you here and rest your hands on the block if that helps you. If you would like to do ragdoll as we hold here, just grasp opposite elbows. Just kind of sway gently from side to side. Or back and forth, just letting head and neck hang loose.
Modern office buildings are chasing the sun, and the wind is racing after the day.
Okay, just remain there in the forward fold, and I will go and see what happened to my music. So just coming to stillness here, we'll all make our way to jackknife posture. So bring your hands to shins or thighs and come about halfway up here. Use your shoulder blades to draw shoulders away from the ears. Crown of the head is facing forward. Should be feeling a pretty good stretch here in the glutes and the hamstrings. So from here, we'll be making our way into Utkatasana or chair pose. I will be offering the use of the block here. So if you do have one and you want to use it, just kind of place it between your thighs, just above the knees. And then begin to sink your hips down. So the use of the block here, just make sure that your inner thighs are just working a little bit harder. Same posture as without the block. Arms reach forward. Unless that bothers your shoulders, then maybe come to prayer pose. And we'll hold here for a few breaths. Adding a twist, just twist towards the left side, bringing your right hand to the outside of that left leg. Remember, twists always come from the waist up and try to maintain a straight spine. So with that in mind, you can stay here or sink a little deeper into the hips and bring your elbow down to your thigh. Make a fist with that right hand and use the palm of your left hand to push against your fist, working a little deeper into the twist. Just take one more breath here. And as you exhale, release the twist. Begin to straighten your legs. And just come back into that forward fold briefly. If you're using the block, you can leave it there or remove it for a moment if that's more comfortable. Just giving the legs a little bit of a break before we add that twist on the opposite side. So again, if you're working with the block, make sure the block is between your thighs. Sinking the hips down, finding that Utkatasana posture. Staying here for a couple of breaths. And then finding that twist on the other side. So try to match what you did on the left side. So taking your left arm to the outside of your right thigh, or taking the elbow down to thigh and sinking a little deeper into the hips. Take one more breath here. Let's unwind the twist. If you have a block, remove it, finding forward fold. One more time, or jackknife, those are your options. And then slowly, just rolling up through the spine, making your way upright, inhaling, reaching arms up to extended mountain, and then drawing hands to heart. So finding yourself in mountain pose, take a couple of breaths here. Just getting used to being upright. And then we're just moving into some sun breaths. So lower your arms. Inhale, sweeping arms up, bringing palms together. Exhale, turning palms out and pushing arms down. Just creating a little bit of a resistance here. Inhale, reaching forward. Exhale, pushing palms down. Let's just do one more. And then adding on, coming into some half sun salutations. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, forward. Inhale, sweeping arms out and up. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, find extended mountain. Legs are strong. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Soft bend in the knees. Inhale, sweeping arms out. Exhale, hands to heart. One more before we add on. Work with your breath. So adding on, we'll move through three sun salutations. Inhale, extended mountain. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, forward. Inhale, finding plank or tabletop is your option. Stay here for a breath or two. On your next exhale, shift forward slightly and just lower down to the mat. Inhale, set shoulders back and make your way to cobra or upward facing dog by just lifting knees off the mat. Inhale here, exhale, downward dog. Inhale, soften knees, look forward. Exhale, make your way to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweeping arms out and up. Exhaling, hands to heart. Two more. Inhale, extended mountain. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Finding plank or tabletop. I'm going to show you the tabletop option here. On your exhale, just lower right down to the mat. Inhale, shoulders back. Stay here in low cobra or push to full cobra or upward dog. Exhaling, downward dog. Inhaling, walk or hop your feet towards the front of the mat. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, jackknife. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweeping your arms out and up. Exhale, hands to heart. One more on your own. Just work with your breath. Inhaling, find that jackknife. Exhale, fold. Making your way to standing whenever you are done. Just pause. Hands to heart. Probably feel your heart beating a little bit faster. And then just releasing your arms down. Be working through some standing postures. I will incorporate the block. It's not necessary to use it. It's definitely doable without. So take an inhale breath here and then keeping your right foot at the top of your mat. Take a step back with your left foot. You probably want to bring your block, if you're using it, just to the left side of your mat. We'll inhale, reaching up, finding warrior one. Exhale, just make your way to warrior two. Just making sure your knee doesn't extend beyond your toe in the front here. Your back toes are facing the long edge of your mat, arms at shoulder height. Hips are fairly even and facing the left side. So this is a very open hip posture, a very go with the flow warrior. And if you're working into triangle from here, just making sure your block is handy. Straightening your front leg. Begin to reach forward like you're reaching across the countertop. And just windmill your arms. So one of the key points of triangle is make sure to keep your chest open and your shoulders stacked. I've seen people in their desperation to reach the floor, leaning forward like this. You're kind of cheating yourself. You'd be better off to have correct alignment and just stay more upright. You can place your hand on your shin. If you can, reach down to the mat, keeping your chest open, then fantastic. Otherwise, another option is to place your hand on a yoga block. And remember, the yoga blocks do technically have three different heights, depending on which way you decide to place them. This is why I like the slightly heavier cork one. It feels a little more stable in this kind of upright position. But there's nothing wrong with the foam ones. They are great. So from here, just releasing triangle. Look into reverse triangle. So bring your back arm down, flip your front palm. Just kind of reach up, opening this front side of the body. Breathing into this right ribcage area. And from here, just make your way back to warrior two. We'll be pivoting to face the front. So you might want to walk this front foot a little behind you, just so that when we do turn to face front, your feet are more on train tracks than a balance beam. It's more stable. So let's pivot on this back foot, sinking down into the front leg. So we're kind of in a lunging warrior one. Reaching arms up if that feels okay. Take a breath here, and on your exhale, just begin to bring fingertips down, coming into runner's lunge. Again, a block can assist you here to keep a straight spine in this runner's lunge. And we will be adding a twist here. So either place your hands on the block or fingertips down to the mat. Or maybe you just bring your hands to your thigh and find the twist that way. So there are plenty options here. If you are using a block, place your hand on the block or fingertips on the floor. Opening right arm to the right on an inhale. Finding that twist, bringing out the spine. Take one more breath, and as you exhale, releasing that right hand down. Step the back leg in slightly and begin to straighten your front leg, coming into a runner's lunge. Options here, hand on a block, hands on your shin, or fingertips down to the floor. And if you want, you can round the spine, bringing nose toward me. That front leg can be bent if you need to bend it. And we will be coming into a revolved triangle from here. So, making sure again the spine is straight, placing fingertips on the block, or maybe just hands on your front shin. You're going to keep your left hand grounded. Maybe you can be up here also with hand on thigh and just find the twist this way. So there are plenty options. Just inhaling here, trying to keep hips level. Again, twist from the waist up, opening your arm to the right. Take an inhale breath here. Exhale, bringing that hand down. Just move your block to the side. Come back into a runner's lunge. And then we'll be stepping back to downward dog. Feel free to just stay here and walk the dog. Or just add a little vinyasa here, a little flow, coming to plank, lowering down. Inhaling, awkward dog. Exhale, downward dog. And bending the knees slightly, we'll step the left foot forward. Set your back heel down, sweeping arms up, making your way to warrior one. If you are using a block, you'll want to make sure you just switch the block to the opposite side of your mat. Take an inhale breath here, and as you exhale, just open up your hips to the right side, making sure hips stay level, finding that warrior two. And from here, making our way to triangle by straightening front leg, leaning forward, and then windmilling the arms, making sure to keep this right shoulder open and back. If you're using the block, just bring it to the inside of your leg here. Place fingertips on the block. Taking one more breath here, then using this top arm to kind of slowly bring you up, windmilling your arms, flipping the front palm up, and finding that reverse triangle, breathing into this left ribcage area. Slowly bending that front knee, making your way back to warrior two. Perhaps taking a moment to walk your front foot behind you a little bit, so towards the left. Then pivoting on that back foot, sinking down, bending your front knee, back leg is straight. Maybe reaching straight up here, finding that lunging warrior one. Inhale here, and as you exhale, bringing hands down, coming into runner's lunge. Again, if you have a block, it can be placed to the inside of your foot. Fingertips or palm of the hand can be placed on the block. other options, fingertips to mat or hands to your front thigh. So just make it work for you. You should be comfortable. You should not be in pain. It's okay to feel a stretch, to feel like something is happening, but you should be able to breathe slowly, deeply, evenly. And from here, adding the twist, opening this left arm, remembering that if you are up here, this could be your twist. Inhaling, on your exhale, lower this arm, step your back foot in a little bit, set the heel, and begin to straighten your front leg as best you can. If you need to keep it bent, then that's fine. And again, you can just round the spine, bringing nose toward knee, or you could stay here with a flat spine, or maybe you're up here. Either one works. This is your own practice. Give your body what it's asking for. Do what you can. No judgment. Don't beat yourself up. And wherever you are in the standing runner, adding that twist by just simply opening your left arm to the left. Again, if you're up here, it works. That's the beautiful part about yoga. Any age, any body type, any body flexibility, we can all do it. On your exhale, bring this arm down. Make your way once more just to runner's lunge. Discard the block here, stepping back to downward dog. Now options here, stay in downward dog, walk the dog. If you're desperate for a break here, just come back to child's pose. We didn't do child's pose yet in this practice, so you can take several breaths here. If you want the challenge, come with me, add a little vinyasa, making your way to plank or tabletop. Just hover here for a breath. And as you exhale, challenge yourself. Try not to touch down here. Try to just make your way to upward dog. Downward dog. And feel free to stay here and maybe walk the dog, or just come down into child's pose. We will be working with pigeon next. So if you do know already that pigeon really does not work in your hips, then your option, which I will quickly show you as you rest there in downward dog or child's pose, is to come onto your back and just find figure four stretch. So you cross one leg over, bring your ankle below the knee, and you can stay right here or lift the other leg up, bringing knee close to your chest and feeling that stretch. You'll feel the stretch in the hip of the leg that's crossed over. And obviously when we do pigeon on the other side, you'll just switch over. So that is your option if you want to be on your back. If you're doing the regular pigeon, just make your way back to downward facing dog. And on your inhale, just come into three-legged dog by lifting your left leg up. As you exhale, sweep knee forward and then set it down. Release your foot to the inside of the thigh and extend your right leg back. And just come up nice and tall here. You should be feeling a pretty good stretch in the right hip flexor. So an option here, which really doesn't work for me because my hip is fairly low to the ground. So maybe a rolled up towel is better, but if you have a sizable space here, you can stick the yoga block right under your hip, if that's more comfortable. Otherwise, you should have a gap here. You should avoid rolling onto the hip. So everybody probably will have some kind of a gap here. Take an inhale breath, and as you exhale, make your way forward. And again, you can pause here on the forearms. If you're not using your block under your hip, you can actually bring your head, your forehead down to the block. Or you can stack your forearms, rest forehead on forearms, or even rest your forehead all the way down on the mat. So you pick whatever works for you. I'm just going to demo with the block here by resting my forehead on the block. Whenever you're ready, slowly make your way upright back to that alert pigeon. Let's move the block out of your way here. Bringing palms to mat. We'll just make our way back to downward dog. Now, I do like to do a downward dog in between pigeon postures because I feel like it stretches my legs out. But if any other posture would work better for you here, if you prefer a child's pose or something else, please feel free to explore that for about 5 or 6 breaths. Already in downward dog, just begin to make your way there. Unless you're on your back, and then you're going to switch legs and work the other side. If you're in downward dog, just take an inhale breath, reaching that right leg nice and high for 3-legged dog. Exhale, sweep the knee forward. Set your knee down, release your foot to the inside of your thumb. Come on up here. Should be feeling a pretty good hip flexor stretch. If you are using the block, you can place it under that right hip. Inhale, and as you exhale, begin to fold forward. And again, options are to stay on the forearms, place the block underneath your forehead, or just come on down, resting your head on the mat. Taking one more breath here. Just slowly begin to make your way upright. If you're on your back, stay right there. And if you're in pigeon, just roll onto one hip and bring this leg forward, finding a seat on the mat. Make sure your block is handy. And just roll on back. We'll be working with bridge pose. As you know, that is obviously very doable without the block. If you are using the block, place it between your thighs and just squeeze your thighs together. So really all this does is help you to engage the inner thighs more so the legs are working a little bit harder. If you don't have a block, you want to engage the inner thighs anyway a little bit just to stop the knees splaying open. Just do a little rolling bridge here. Inhaling, lifting up your hips. Exhaling, lower down. Inhale, lift the hips. Exhale, lower, rolling down those vertebrae one at a time. And just continue here for a few more. If you are really enjoying this rolling bridge, you can stay here. But if you do want the challenge of just holding the posture, the next time you feel your hips coming up, just pause there. Maybe walk your shoulder blades in towards one another. Palms down, push in to the forearms. Engaging your inner thighs, glutes are working. We'll try to hold for a few more breaths. Anytime you can come back into that rolling bridge. If you have a block and you wish to remove it, just take it out. Let's take one more breath here. And then slowly begin to lower your hips. Discard your block if you were using it. Draw in your knees. And just rock here gently from side to side. Or perhaps just circling your knees in one direction, kind of massaging the low back. And then pause and circle in the opposite direction. And then just coming to stillness, extend your legs straight up, flex your feet coming into hip stem. And from here just point and flex your feet. Maybe circle the ankles. Bending the knees one at a time. Getting the synovial fluid flowing in those knee joints, giving them some lubrication. And extending your legs up, extending your arms up, maybe just giving everything a good shake. And then come into stillness, flexing your feet, interlace your fingers and place hands behind your head. Take an inhale breath. On your exhale, just gently lift your head, bringing chin towards chest. So avoid tugging too hard on your neck. And just breathe here, flexing your feet, feeling a nice stretch down the back and a little compression to your thyroid gland here. Taking one more breath. Just slowly lower the head down, bring feet down to mat. Just take a moment to allow the knees to fall gently from side to side. And we'll come into one final posture, which will be our knee down twist. Extend your left leg long and draw your right knee in. Now, I will be using the block here. Again, as you know, it is not necessary here. Take your right arm out to shoulder height and use your left arm to guide this knee over towards the left. Now, if lower back is tight, you'll want to keep knee off the mat, so it is nice to place this yoga block just underneath the knee. And again, it does have different heights. So you can make it what you need it to be. If you're a little more flexible in the low back, or you just don't have a block, you can feel free to stay here or take your left hand and just gently ease your right knee a little closer to the floor. So again, get what you need out of this. Give your body what it is asking for.
and slowly just making your way onto your back. If you are using a block, just move it to the other side. Gather in both knees, take a breath here. And then extend your right leg long. Bring left arm out to shoulder height and use your right arm to guide this knee over, across and down to the right. You can choose to use the yoga block or not. You can keep your knee at hip height or gently encourage it towards the floor. Lay here enjoying this twist. Breathing into this upper chest area. Taking one more breath here. Just slowly roll onto your back. And just gather in your knees and rock gently from side to side. And as we prepare for Shavasana, just think about if you need to grab a blanket or a sweater, jumper, or some socks. About how you'll want to spend your Shavasana today. Maybe you move your mat over to one of the walls and elevate your legs, resting your feet against the wall. Maybe you lay here with your feet flat on the floor, knees bent, giving the low back some support. Either way, we'll listen to the words of Gary Lightbody and we'll just forget the world. If you want, you can extend your legs out. You can extend your arms out. Just let everything roll out to the side. Or maybe you're more comfortable laying on one side. So just find that comfortable position. Begin to mentally scan your body one more time. Where are you holding on to tension? Just let it go. Pay attention to the support points of the floor beneath you. And taking an inhale breath as you exhale. Fully surrender into the support of the earth. Let your breathing be natural. Just try to keep the mind quiet, thoughts to a minimum. Just try to focus on the sound of your own soft breathing.
Oh no.
begin to bring your attention back to the present moment, taking in the sounds around you, or noting how the air feels on your skin. Just making some small movements here to begin to waken the body. Maybe gathering in your knees and rocking gently from side to side, or taking an overhead stretch. And then maybe choosing to roll on to one side for a few breaths. And then taking your time whenever you're ready, just transition to a seated position.
Sink into your arms and all I see. Love is an ocean.
And then taking an inhale breath, reaching arms out and up. Bringing palms together and drawing hands to heart center. The light in me honors the light in you. Namaste.